Welcome to the Cisco Catalyst Center training series for industrial switching. My name is Krishna Divakar, Technical Marketing Engineer for Industrial Switching at Cisco. In today's video, we will be diving into the world of Power over Ethernet and we'll take a look at our Intuitive PoE dashboard. We will also learn how the dashboard simplifies PoE management and helps to increase efficiency. Before we proceed, let's take a quick look at what PoE is all about. In recent times, PoE has been a game-changer technology in how we power our devices over the Ethernet cables. This brings flexibility and efficiency to our network installations. This technology delivers DC power over standard copper Ethernet cabling. This means you could power your devices like cameras, access points, etc. through the cable that transmits the data. The key advantage here lies in its ability to reduce the need for separate power sources and connections. Imagine a scenario deploying an IP camera without having to worry about the proximity to the power outlet. Though PoE offers a lot of benefits, it's not free from challenges. One of the fundamental challenges in PoE is power budgeting. PoE switches have limited amount of power they can supply to its connected devices. And also, different devices use different power levels, so the calculation becomes really important. Next comes the device compatibility. Understanding the device compatibility is essential to make sure the PoE switch can deliver the necessary power without exceeding its limits. One of the major requirements in the PoE monitoring is fault detection. What we mean by fault detection is how quickly we identify issues such as power outages or the devices drawing excess power. The quicker we identify the faults, it becomes easier for the admins to take proactive measures. PoE monitoring becomes easier with the Catalyst Center. It has a rich dashboard that can provide you with information such as power usage, the number of PoE ports available, power distribution, and the operational state. Every organization today has a sustainability goal. Catalyst Center helps you out in that aspect as well. It can provide you the estimated power savings when you run the access points in the power save mode. Let's now log into the Catalyst Center and see these things in action. Once you are logged into the Catalyst Center, click on the hamburger menu, choose Assurance, and then PoE. This will bring up the PoE dashboard page. The first thing you would need to do is choose the site you are interested in and the time frame. The page also provides you with the insights on the supported platforms and the minimum iOS XE versions needed. Down below, you have various dashlets providing information about the PoE in your network. The top ones are specific to the PoE devices and the ones in the bottom are specific to the switches powering them. The first dashlet provides you the information about the number of PoE devices in your network. You could click here to find more information about the connected devices, like the device type, the switch they are connected to, and the power allocated to them. If there are any devices in your network which are either faulty or in power denied state, that would show up here. You could also click on the switch name here, which would take you to the Device 360 page. Once you are on the Device 360 page, you could click on the PoE option to find more information about the PoE status on the switch. There is a table below which would give you information about the PoE interfaces, the connected devices, the type, and the amount of power allocated to them. You could also click on the port reset button here. Which would take you to this page where you can take some action on the port, like shut them down or bring it up. The next tile gives you the information about how the power is distributed across the power devices. There is also a tile for PoE Insights, which gives you the information about the type of PoE devices you have in your network, like the ones which are IEEE compliant, which are capable of FOSS PoE, and so on. Down below, you have the tiles providing you the information about the switches powering these devices. With the power usage dashlet, you could find out the amount of power budget available and the allocation that is currently made. The next tile talks about how the load is distributed among the switches available in your site. Traditionally, administrators found it difficult to identify the free ports available in your network. You would have to log into each and every switch to find out the power budget and the allocation available. Consider a situation where you have a 60-watt device to be connected to your site. You could just come in here, click on this chart, and easily identify the switch that is capable of providing the power. As we discussed earlier, there are also dashlets that help you out with the sustainability goals. For instance, this dashlet here can give you the information about the number of APs you have in your network that can run in power saving mode. The next dashlet here gives you the information about the amount of power that was saved by running those APs in the power saving mode. The collected data is then categorized and displayed. This is how you would manage the PoE in your network using the Catalyst Center. Hope you found this information useful, and thank you for watching.